Yes, very good morning, sir. So on behalf of placement and commerce department, we the faculties invite you for the session, sir. You have been associated with us for the past 2 years and you have been contributing more than two sessions for the semester. We welcome you once again, sir. Our student representative will welcome you on behalf of all of us, sir. Thank you, sir. So I invite now Shyam to give a welcome address.
Very good morning to all. I take a privilege to welcome you all for this virtual guest lecture titled Mutual Funds, organizing jointly by Department of Training, Placement and Department of Commerce, Dhanaraj Bain Jain College. First of all, I would like to express my sincere thanks to the college management and professor in charge, Dr. M. Shaktivel Murugan, sir, for arranging training programs, guest lecture to develop our skills. On behalf of management, professor in charge and Department of Commerce and Department of Training and Placement, I welcome our chief guest, Mr. Francis Felix, sir, today for the session. Mr. Francis Felix, sir, a retired bank manager with experience of 17 years, a finance manager, knowledge enrichment session to share your rich experience exclusively for our DBGEN students. I request our chief guest to take over the session.
Good morning and welcome to this particular platform. I'm audible to everybody.
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, before proceeding further, the reason is this is a topic which I'm going to take play coming to you. It's called mutual fund. Normally, people talk about mutual fund. You have seen an advertisement. You have seen Sachin Tendulkar speaking about mutual fund. You have seen Mahendra Dhoni speaking of mutual fund. What is this mutual fund? That is everybody's mind. It is now lingering actually. Actually, in Tamil, it is called Parasparan Nidhin Peru in Tamil, actually. What is this mutual fund? It is nothing but is another investment product which is in the market. Just another investment product. But the investment product, what you're going to take normally, for example, once you go out of the college and go for a job, you get your first salary. What will you do? You'd open an RD account, recurring deposit. That is also an investment product, but it is connected with a bank. But in a mutual fund, it is entirely a different scenario, a different picture. How is this different picture? See, I'm a raw graduate getting into a job environment. I want to become a shareholder of a company. I'm just starting my life. How can I become a shareholder of a company? The only thing, you can aim high, but the problem is to reach that milestone, there are certain avenues you have to follow it up. That avenues is one such avenue. There are two things. Either you can, to become a shareholder of a company, you have to invest in stock market. That is by getting a share, investing in stock market, being a representative of some company as a shareholder, and then you get a dividend, everything. The second route, what we have is called a mutual fund. By investing in stock market, there is some risk factor is there, actually, a risk factor is there. But here, there is no risk factor, actually. It is you are going to be, how I'll put it in such a way, say, once you enter a job, and get into a job or something, you want to buy a new two-wheeler. That two-wheeler, when it comes to your house, it is something new what you are going to have it in your hand. And you want to take it as and when and drive it and look after it like that. And as the days goes by, the two-wheeler also goes with you until you want to change into another two-wheeler. The same process, this investment of mutual fund is also going to be with you. Simply, the broad perspective, in a broader sense, how would we call it as a mutual fund is a type of a financial vehicle made up of some of money collected from various investors. See, various investors, there are in a mutual fund, you are also be a part. There may be another, X amount of investors would have done. From all of them, they collect money. And the reason is to invest in securities. Securities means in shares. In securities like stocks. Stocks means share market, bonds, and money market instrument. Stocks are investment in share market is one kind of thing comes into a mutual fund. Bonds, but that is a bonds, say, for example, when you go into a fixed deposit, that deposit gives you X amount of rate of interest on a regular basis. It is a guaranteed return, and it is called a debt instrument. As far as in people who are done commerce will have know what is a debt instrument. So in the same fashion, if whatever debt security is coming into the market, it is also connected with a mutual fund that is called bonds. Then money market instrument. What is this money market instrument? There are two banks, say Indian Bank and Karur Vysya Bank. These two broad banks, what they do, they have a funds crisis. Some internal funds crisis come. They approach the Reserve Bank of India. At that time, Reserve Bank says, I can give you the permission. You itself draw a kind of a promissory note, a kind of a deed or something that I will pay this in particular point. That kind of an instrument is called, for a shorter period, is called a money market instrument. Okay, so a mutual fund goes through stocks, bonds, and money market instrument. This is how it is. And mutual funds are operated by a professional managers called asset management company manager, AMC managers, who allocate these funds and assets to generate gain or income for the further investing. Say, for example, you put in a fixed deposit. The fixed deposit gets 7.5% rate of interest, they say, after 5 years. After 5 years, you get that return rate of interest guaranteed. What will happen? Initially, you will put 15,000. Then what will you say? Okay, I got a very good return. Let me put another 10,000 for another 5 years. Normally, your investment habit continues. Like that only, in a mutual fund, once you get a return good, automatically people go start investing. That is how the mutual fund industry, the mutual fund concept had come. In a mutual fund, there are certain terminology which you have to follow. Like when you open a bank account, you get a statement that is called a savings statement. In a mutual fund, it is called a portfolio. That because it is connected with shares and debentures and all this criteria, it is called a portfolio account. And in a account, when you pay, it is X amount of rupees, it says. But in a mutual fund account, what is the price of a mutual fund is one that is called NAV. It is called net asset value per share. Net asset value, they say, in a per share. Then in a bank, when you put a savings amount, you get a return of interest also on a regular basis. In the same fashion, in a mutual fund, periodically the mutual fund company declare a dividend. That is the income what you earn from a mutual fund. The person managing the fund is called a fund manager. And the company which is dealing with that is called asset management company. Like an insurance company, like a bank, it is called an asset management company. Why it is called an asset? Because that fund where it's, say, it comprises of stocks, bonds, and money market. In a normal people who have done commerce, they will understand. It is called an asset. So that is the reason why it is an asset management company. All these activities are happening. It is controlled by one particular body. It's called SEBI, Security Exchange Board of India. Without SEBI's knowledge, nothing can happen. That's the idea behind. As far as mutual fund is concerned, the returns, what is the returns? It is the returns. It is only the what the market, stock market gives. That return only you can expect. It is not an assured return. So it is a fluctuating, like a river flowing in a normal way. Suddenly the river comes with an high tide. Like that, it is a fluctuating kind of return, and it is not an assured return. So people entering into a mutual fund always stay for a longer time. The longer time they stay, they get the return better. That's the whole idea about a mutual fund. Why you invest in a mutual fund? Next question. The reason is, it is professionally managed. Professionally managed, you got some expert people taking care of this particular exercise. Easy liquidity. Say, for example, when you put in a fixed deposit, what happened? In case 3 months run, after that you want to break that deposit, 1% penalty they take. But here, that is not the case. When you want money, you can easily redeem it. It is called redemption of mutual fund. You can easily redeem. Then there is a tax bracket is also there. Tax benefit also. People who have gone into a salary bracket for under Section 80C, this tax benefit is taken in the mutual fund. Then the administration part is very convenient. There is no cumbersome process. You got a simple form. All the guidelines are there. Read the form, understand it, and then do the investment. The cost factor is very low. There is no charges. Only, say, for example, you enter into any mutual fund, the first 6 months, you can't come out of that fund. After 6 months, if you come, there is no charges. But in case people, they invest on the first month, if they want to come out in the third month, definitely 1% charges are taken. Like that, so certain things are taken care. It's very low, actually. And also, the investor protection is well regulated because all said and done, it is controlled by SEBI. The guidelines are very strict and there is no chance of people getting into malpractice or misguiding. All everything is there. So that is also there. And also the return is potential. Potential in sense, the longer you stay, the better you return. The longer you stay means normal practice, it says 5%. 5% is the thing given as far as the mutual fund is concerned, 5%. And also the return is potential. And the return, and it has a reduction of diversified risk means, say, for example, a person wants to put money in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 funds on a different nature. One fund performs well, the other three, other three is not performing also. One, you get a return on a regular basis. That is the idea behind actually. Next one, I just want to tell you the types of mutual fund. There are the types of mutual fund are into various category. First, we are looking into an open-end mutual fund. What is this open-end mutual fund? An open-end mutual fund, it is traveling in the gray market, that is stock market, anytime you can purchase it. And it is available for subscription on a continuous basis. Anytime you can buy that, that is no problem. And this, it has no maturity. Open-end fund means you can enter into that fund, see the returns for one particular time, come out of the fund. Then after some time, you can have some money. Again, you can put money in the same fund. This is the idea as far as the open-end fund is concerned. Closed-end fund. Closed-end fund means there is a fixed time maturity between 5 to 7 years. And this particular funds opens for a week on a particular period. And then within a week, you have to purchase it. Within a week, you can't get into that fund because it's a closed-end fund. That's the idea behind. Then we have this fund called equity fund. Equity fund is the basic thing. People take equity. They are not worried about the risk, but the categorized, they want to see the market fluctuation also doesn't matter. So it is for a medium-term, long-term purposes. As far as the whatever money they put, the capital should grow. In that context, people invest this equity fund. Then you have an income fund where it is a fund which is not such fluctuating as an equity fund, where people get a steady income on a regular basis. Like regular basis means, as I earlier said, they invest in bonds, government securities, and money market instrument, this income fund. Then you have a balance fund. This balance, especially people having children, for the children education, they go into the balance fund. Why they go into a balance fund means that in a balance fund, say that a 65% will be in debt instrument, only 35 will be in the market exposure. So on a regular basis, the fund also performs well, and for the children betterment, they can withdraw that money from there. Then you have the fund called a gilt fund. This is also whatever a time period Reserve Bank that brings certain government securities, and in that only people invest, and there is no risk involved. And then you have an index fund. An index fund, it is a each mutual fund has an index, and that particular index, people get into that index fund. Why they get into that index fund, there is no risk is involved, because as the market goes high and market come down, it gives a return on a regular basis. Then you have an hybrid fund. An hybrid fund is a combination of an equity fund and a debt fund. People also get into such kind of fund. These are some of the types of funds available in the market. In a mutual fund, everybody can put a big money into it. There are people who want to have some small money also. They are on a regular, on a monthly basis, for which there is a route called SIP, S-I-P-SIP. It is systematic investment plan. A systematic, like your normal EMI, what you pay for a two-wheeler loan, or a standing order you pay for a in a bank, like that it is. A systematic method, a systematic plan is a method of investing a fixed sum at regular intervals over a definite time frame. It is very simple and similar to small savings like post office savings. What is the advantage? It is a convenient way to invest regularly and a low-cost initial investment, and help the investors to smooth out the market fluctuation. If there is a fluctuation, it eases out the market fluctuation, reduce the risk associated also, and helps in meeting the requirements of the objective of the investor. And it is for a long-term perspective. People, this is one route people look into it. Next is, in a mutual fund, there is a category called ELSS. ELSS means equity-linked savings scheme. Equity-linked savings scheme, you have the name itself. So entire thing goes into the stock market. This is mainly taken by why these people get into it, especially people having a salary bracket. The government gives a concession up to 1,50,000 rupees under Section 80C. The people can park the money into this ELSS fund. In this ELSS fund, the regular returns are close to, it's been given around 12 to 15% the returns are there. But the problem is, when you invest into the ELSS fund, once you invest, within the lock-in period is 3 years. You can't come out of the fund in between. So 3 years is a lock-in period. And the people, mainly salaried bracket individuals, they get into this ELSS fund because after 3 years, the first time in the invest, they get the tax benefit also. After 3 years, they get the return also. So it is a twin benefit which gives actually. And all these say, for a normal banking account, banking transaction, you have a savings account. Like that, for a mutual fund, you have a demat account. Earlier, that is post 2000, earlier when mutual fund industry started, everything was in a physical format. But now they have made it a demat format. Demat means it is dematerialized thing, kind of a document actually. It is mainly for holding security transaction in an electronic form. This demat is maintained by two organization in India. One is an NSDL and another is CDSL. NSDL is National Security Depository Limited, or CSDL is Central Depository Securities India Limited. What is the KYC given for this? The KYCs are driving license or passport, income proof, or proof of bank and cancelled check, and a PAN card, and 3 passport size photograph has to be given as far as the demat account is concerned. Now I'm going to come to look into it, the tax implication on this mutual fund. Only 2 types of tax are at present is there. One is, there is a capital gain tax. What is this capital gain tax? For example, you invest in a mutual fund in a particular period, say for in a ELSS fund in 2016, an X amount you put. But in 2019, the maturity you want to take, the mutual fund has grown up from that particular amount to another amount. So that when a profit what you earn, for which there is a tax has been taken care. I think it's around 10%, I think, actually. It depends on the mutual fund. Then there is a dividend distribution tax. When you put in a mutual fund, the dividends are free, actually. Dividends are free. And the tax was earlier paid by the fund house itself. But I think in the recent budget, I think that the tax has to be paid. This 2021 budget, this dividend is also taxable. That's what the new finance minister has brought out. And another thing I want to tell you, is mutual fund is better than FD? Yes, higher returns it gives more than the FD actually. And it is for a short term, it is actually, you can put it for maximum is 5 years. And there is another fund called a liquid fund also. The liquid fund, most of the mutual fund companies are holding that. The reason is the liquid fund, you can enter into the fund anytime. If you want, you can come out. You can then go back into it. That kind of a facility is there. And also, periodically, what happened is, during that March, that is February, March, April, government brings certain kind of funds, which just gives you a tax exemption. And in that also, people do this investment as far as the mutual fund is concerned. Another thing I just want to share with you, this in a mutual fund, as far as I earlier said, you have a share market perspective. That was share market is divided into two categories. One is NSE, another is BSE. The NSE is called National Stock Exchange, and the BSE is Bombay Stock Exchange. In between, there is another stock which is floating in the share market. It's called Nifty 100. Nifty 100 is actually the top 100 shares which will be constantly performing. That is also there. Then, I have already told you, equity fund. This equity fund is divided into four categories. It is called a small cap fund, a large cap fund, mid cap fund, and multi cap fund. If what is a small cap fund is that is a company which has a less than 500 crores, that category, that is called a small cap fund. Large cap is higher than 20,000 crores. Mid cap fund is 2,000 to 10,000 crores. And multi cap is, it is a combination of large, small, and mid cap. That's how it is. Then you have a fund called a blue chip fund. This blue chip fund is simply a company which is giving you a dividend on a periodic basis, and also on a periodic basis, they declare dividend. This dividend, what they declare, and also the profitability is there, that is also given as a blue chip fund is called. When you're investing in a mutual fund, one thing you have to see, when you study that particular fund, you have to look into the PE ratio, that is called percentage earning ratio. What is this percentage earning ratio? Each mutual fund has a ratio category, how does it perform? The ratio category, that it is given two dimension, it is between 13 to 15, actually. Say, any mutual fund has a ratio above 15, it's a very good performance-oriented fund. Any mutual fund on a particular basis, which has a ratio of, that is below 13, it is has some certain thing because the fund house is not taking care or the asset fund manager is not doing well, all kinds of things. So this particular thing you have to keep in mind while investing in mutual fund. This is how the mutual fund industry as far as they. Certain examples I want to give you as far as the mutual fund, this which is available in the market, anything. For example, I said SIP, systematic. You have a fund called SBI Blue Chip Fund. You have a fund called Access Blue Chip Fund, where the investment period is only for 5 years. After 5 years, you can come out, actually. Then, as I earlier said, it is a debt fund. Debt fund means it gives you however market fluctuate, however market is volatile, that 8% is there for you as far as the debt is concerned. That debt fund, you have this HDFC short-term debt fund and Aditya Birla Sun Life Saving Fund. This is called a debt fund. As far as the equity is concerned, there is a large cap, mid cap, multi cap, and small cap is there. In a large cap fund, you can get into a Canara Robeco Blue Chip Fund. And in a mid cap is Invesco India Mid Cap Fund. And also multi cap is Canara Robeco Equity Diversified Plan Fund. And also you go into this ELS category, Canara Robeco Equity Fund, Bank of India AXA Tax Diversifying Fund, and BNP Paribas Long Term Fund. These are the broad categories you have. For example, anybody wants to do a mutual fund investment, very simple. There is a website called moneycontrol.com. You can go into it. You need not register. It is open for all. Just go into it. On the scrolling page, if you put equity mutual fund, it gives you that list of top performing mutual fund, their name, and also what is the ranking they give, actually. Besides that, you have the daily rates also there. All these are taken into category. You can understand, you can study that, and then get into this mutual fund thing. Especially, you need for investing a stock, you need a broker to do the investment. For investing a mutual fund, you need not have a broker. You can itself do. Simple, you have a savings account, you have a DMAT account. In your DMAT account itself, once you open a DMAT account, now periodically all these mutual funds, what I said to you now, will be in the page itself. Whichever mutual fund you want, you can buy, you can sell there itself. Another thing, in a mutual fund, there is one category called new fund offer. What is this new fund offer? The new fund offer, periodically, people get into it because normally when you get into a mutual fund, you want to buy from the stock market, that present NAV rate, what is going in the market, say 250 for this particular, as a Sundaram Diversified is 250, it is trading today. That only you can purchase. But in NFO, it starts with 10 rupees. 10 rupees means from 10 rupees, it travels actually. 10 rupees it travels actually. And the 10 rupees onwards it travels. So this particular mutual fund, you can purchase it at that particular point. You can purchase at a particular point. And this particular mutual fund, at 10 rupees mutual fund, it stays for a week. During this 10 rupees, during this particular period, that 1 week period, you can buy it. But once the NFO closes, automatically what happens is, you have to get into the gray market and get the, from 10 it moves on. So normally people, what they do, they get into it, buy this one. Okay? I have completed, madam. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Any questions?
No questions, sir. Please continue, sir.
No, I've completed my lecture. Only people have to ask questions.
Sure, sir. Sure. So, yes, any questions, students?
And you have to have your PAN card. Without the PAN card, you can't do this mutual fund thing. Any questions? Any basic questions?
So something on always we see a note, mutual funds investments are subject to market risk. Please read the offer documents. Something related to that, sir?
See, why they put this mutual fund is subject to risk? Because why, I'll tell you, as I said, it is not an assured return. It is only the market returns, I said earlier. Because based on that, the market, whatever it gives on a regular basis, based on that, the return come. So before going into any mutual fund, you should read that offer document. What is that fund? Where the asset, the manager invests, on what kind of second does he do? Does he put his entire investment into equity? Does he put his investment into debt? This analyzation you have to do. Okay. That's the reason why they give that. Because why, I'll tell you, lot of people without understanding it, so they get into the mutual fund. Understood? The time, and another thing, in a mutual fund system, you can't time the market. If I put this money, another 5 years, I will be getting the return successfully. Depends on the market also. The market also has to give. But in a mutual fund industry, traditionally, the longer you stay, the better the returns. The longer you stay, the better the returns. That is it. In between, you can't break it. For example, in ELSS fund, 3 years, people can't come out of it, in fact. Because the question is, That's our system is like that only. That's the reason why that they put subject to market risk, read offer documents before you do. As you have seen Sachin Tendulkar ad, I don't know how many people have seen. One lady will ask, is it the cricket is a very risky factor? How my son is going to encounter? Sachin will say, have you invested in mutual fund? See, he's putting paradox between the mutual fund. See, that is also, unless you take a risk, you can't get that returns. But the returns are, it is a, as I said, if it gives, it gives in a very good returns. Sometimes, it is not only on the fund performance, it is also the global situation is also there. That is also there. The global market also has to factor for this mutual fund thriving actually.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Shamini?
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon. It was indeed a privilege to have Mr. Francis Felix, Financial Education Counselor, ICICI Foundation for Inclusive Growth. His insightful lecture on mutual funds was full of information and wisdom. He shared with the students as a special note on focus on types of mutual fund with written on investment from stock market. Once again, I thank you, sir, for having spared your precious time for all of us. I express my profound gratitude to our management, Principal in Charge, Dr. Shaktivel Murugan, sir, Department of Placement and Training, for organizing such a thought-provoking session. Thank you all for the success of the online webinar session. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. On behalf of college management,
yes, madam.
Dr. Shaktivela Murugan, professor in charge, sir. So without their support, we can't do it out anything. So with their support only, we are doing continually webinars during this lockdown period also. So okay, thank you so much for your continuous support, because in this semester, this is the third program by yourself. So still we are expecting so much. Students, any feedback about the program? Anyone can unmute their mic and tell. Students, expecting your feedback, ma?
Yes, it was very informative. Thank you very much for the session. Expecting much more session by you regarding those banks. Very thankful.
Yeah. When there is an updation in the market, I'll definitely approach madam. And a lot of changes are going to come by the year end. In fact, definitely. Year end, you're going to see a lot of changes. And a lot of things you have to see. You are actually hassle-free, you're traveling so far. Year after, you have to be in a cumbersome mode. So certain restrictions also are there. So you have to get accustomed to such kind of restriction. That's how it's going to be.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Welcome. The session was very informative, sir. Thank you very much on behalf of management, commerce department and everyone. So I think it was so very informative session for the students, sir. Thanks a lot, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Manu. Welcome.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.